स्पिरिट बिहाइंड विवेकानंदा रॉक मेमोरियल एंड विवेकानंदा केंद्रा, एकनाथ जी रानड़े, कन्याकुमारी, इंडिया सदर्न मोस्ट टिप, फीट ऑफ भारत माता वॉश्ड बाय थ्री ओशंस, इंडियन ओशन, अरेबियन सी एंड बे ऑफ बंगाल. हियर स्टैंड्स विवेकानंदा रॉक मेमोरियल, अ मॉन्यूमेंट बिल्ट इन 1970 इन हॉनर ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंदा, हु इज सेड टू हैव अटेन्ड एनलाइटनमेंट ऑन दिस रॉक. Swami Vivekananda, fondly called as Wandering Monk, when he reached Kanyakumari, was painful about how people of Bharat had degenerated into utter poverty, ignorance and loss of self-confidence. He prayed to Bhagavati Kanyakumari, saw this rock, swam to the rock and meditated. That was in 1892, from December 25th to 27th. After this, he went to World Parliament of Religions and presented Hindu Dharma to the world at large. In the year 1963, the birth centenary of Swami Vivekananda was being celebrated all over the country. The people of Kanyakumari wanted to build a memorial for Swami Vivekananda on that very historic rock. Unfortunately, a section of Christian community was instigated and it started demanding that the memorial of Saint Xavier should be built on the rock. To fabricate their claim, they erected a big stone cross on the rock. It became a communal issue. Government took a stand that it was Vivekananda Rock, but no memorial should be built on it. The Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee decided to approach Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh for deputy Eknath Ji Ranade for the work. Destiny took Sri Eknath Ranade to the purpose for which he was born. He was requested by Guruji Golwalkar to take up the cause of establishing the Vivekananda Rock Memorial. Once he dedicated himself to the cause, he made it his mission to tour the country, meet political leaders, businessmen, discuss the idea of memorial at Kanyakumari with them, convince them to participate in the process in whichever the way they could, and started asking for money. But was it an easy task? No. He became the organizing secretary of Vivekananda Rock Memorial on August 11, 1963. Humayun Kabir, the then Union Cultural Affairs Minister, and Bhaktavatsalam, the then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, were not in much favor of the idea of Vivekananda Rock Memorial. Ranade decided to first convince Humayun Kabir. Ranade went to Calcutta, Humayun Kabir's constituency, spread the word about the memorial plan, and then addressed a press conference with a mention that Humayun Kabir was not in favor of it. Then Ranade went to Bhaktavatsalam. Despite discussions, when it appeared that Bhaktavatsalam was not convinced fully about the memorial, Ranade decided to meet senior Congress leader Lal Bahadur Shastri, seeking his guidance. Shastri approved of Ranade's idea of collecting signatures of members of parliament on a petition for the memorial and submitting the petition to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the then Prime Minister. Within 3 days, Ranade had collected 323 signatures. A stern Shastri himself went to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and the next day, Pandit Nehru made a statement that Government of India would very much like to have Swami Vivekananda's statue on the rock. This softened Bhaktavatsalam, and he said that he had never objected to the statue on the rock. One man's efforts united political leaders of the nation towards a greater cause, cutting across political barriers. As it stands today, Vivekananda Rock Memorial comprises of three main features: Vivekananda Mandapam, Sripada Mantapam, and ferry service. With Ranade's tireless efforts in crossing every obstacle and inspiring the team of Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee, the work was completed in March 1970. There was a grand inauguration. V.V. Giri, the then Prime Minister of India, inaugurated the Rock Memorial on September 2, 1970. K. Karunanidhi, the then Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, presided over the function. The second phase of the Rock Memorial, the living memorial, in other words, Vivekananda Kendra, was in Eknath Ranade's vision almost as soon as the first phase was underway. Ranade was not a man who would stop at the rock memorial. By this time, he had crystallized an idea of a living memorial to Swami Vivekananda in the form of body of volunteers. Accordingly, during the drive for a collection of funds for the Rock Memorial, he decided to collect funds from every state of India, including the far eastern state like Nagaland. Through this, he took Vivekananda's work to every nook and corner of the country. Sri Ekanath Ranade was a prolific and punctilious letter writer. Since he took charge as the organizing secretary of Vivekananda Rock Memorial Committee in 1963 till his death in 1982, he wrote over 25,000 letters. He procured land in Kanyakumari to establish the headquarters of Vivekananda Kendra, known as Vivekananda Puram. Apart from being involved in the publication activities of the Kendra in periodicals Yuvabharati and Kendra Bharati, Ekanathji also took series of lectures for Jeevanavrittis. On 22nd August 1982, Sri Ekanath Ranade suffered a massive and fatal heart attack in Chennai. His body was brought to Kanyakumari and cremated on 23rd August. As the sun set and the saffron flag with Om was lowered on the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, the pyre was lit.